coin it will all season long. The Blues offense has suddenly left them high and dry. Only 3 goals scored in the last 4 games combined. Tonight, the youthful and highly talented Edmonton Oilers roll into town in the midst of a 9-game road trip. Can the Blues drill their way to a win here at home? The puck drops next on Fox Sports Midwest. And time to check tonight's top starting goaltenders. Halak goes for the 4th consecutive game on home ice this year. Is 3-1. Devin Dubnyk, the 26-year-old, goes for the Oilers. Last night stopped 34 of 35 in the 5-1 victory. Blues hockey is brought to you by Bud Light. It's the sure sign of a good time. Here we go. And right off the opening faceoff, we get an offside. The Blues with Backes, Oshie, and Jaden Schwartz. A new look first line from Coach Ken Hitchcock with Petrangelo and Jackman on defense.
Yeah, so different pairings on the blue line as well as they really try to shuffle the deck here. Ian Cole out of the lineup, and the veteran Wade Redden gets a chance to get right back into it.
Ryan Nugent-Hopkins on with Jordan Eberle, and Taylor Hall with Nick Schultz and Justin Schultz, no relation, on defense. And the Blues get it back for Petrangelo. Comes to center, and then smashed back in by Jackman. And a quick change by the Blues. And it's handled by Nick Schultz.
And you notice the Blues have got the pink laces or pink tape, as it's pink at the rink here tonight at Scottrade Center.
And they throw it all the way down. Hemsky takes a hit back of the goal from Shattenkirk. And now Hemsky again. Worked over by Shattenkirk. Shared on defense with Redden. Now back of the goal, Gagne in front. Good coverage there, but the Blues get a stick in the lane, and Shattenkirk breaks it up, and here's Stewart away for the Blues. Down is off wing. Schmid back of the goal. Now he gives it up, and David Perron in there. Here's Perron. Gets it near the line. Berglund, good job to hold it in. And now the Blues go off on a change. Oilers played in Dallas last night. Got to their hotel about 2 in the morning. It's the 3rd game of a 9-game road trip over 17 days.
And then, well, they lost in overtime against the mighty Blackhawks, and then they turned around and won in Dallas, so 3 or 4 points.
And Vladdy's the bulk of a shot out there with D'Agostini and Porter. Now Ryan Smith, the veteran, trying to split the Blues' defense, but he was shouldered off the puck by Pollock. And the Blues shoot it down the ice. And Ryan Whitney, who's been a healthy scratch for 4 straight games. Back defensively on the forecheck, D'Agostini. Puck pops to center ice, and it's grabbed by Yakupov. A shot, and he hits the outside of the Blues' goal. The 19-year-old, the first overall pick in last year's draft, Nail Yakupov, number 64. And back on the line, a drive by Justin Schultz. That was tipped off the glass. And now recovered by D'Agostini. Hands it on to Russell. And the Blues get it across the red line and in deep. Adam Tucker was first crack with the Blues this year. And his mom and dad are watching in Victoria, B.C. Checked in by Petrangelo. Now Petrangelo works back to the goal. Here's Prachtel and a shot, and that goes right through a maze of players and a glove save by Dubnyk.
Great play there by Adam Prachtel. He's got a wicked snapshot right there as we take a look at our Toyota keys to the game on this Friday night here at Scottrade Center. And not the same exuberant crowd as we saw last night, but you've got to play for the guy beside you. They're going through a little lump on the road right now, and it's about what you're willing to do for your teammate. And tighten up in the neutral zone as well. Those will be some big keys in this game as the Blues will embark on a big road swing after this one.
Here comes Eberle, a shot. That goes high and wide. As Hitchcock told us in our meeting, we're in some rough seas right now. We got to bring the boat in.
No cavalry coming, huh?
I don't believe so. And Halak plays one to the corner for Petrangelo. And now on to Oshie. Center ice for Berglund. Wheels into the Edmonton zone for Jack, but a shot. And that's blocked by the stick of Jeff Petrie. And it goes out of play.
Well, the Blues coming into the 5-man unit on a line change as well. So good support by the man with the puck there, Berglund, in our Plaza Tire Service replay. Now he's going to utilize the left side of the ice, which is your weak side defenseman, Jackman, jumping up into the play. And although that puck gets deflected, you like to see the Blues come out up and back in 5-man units. And we'll see how this line gets going, too. You know, Berglund and with Perron on his left and Chris Stewart on the right.
Season low 21 shots last night, as Darren mentioned, and you can expect and hope that the Blues will get more pucks toward the net and more traffic in front of Devan Dubnyk. And that's chopped away, and we'll get a faceoff back at center ice.
Well, for Ralph Krueger, who took over the reins for Tom Rennie, who's now an assistant coach with the Detroit Red Wings. Krueger in his first season, got a feel for it last year, working alongside veteran defenseman Steve Smith, who had a great NHL career. But there looked to be a very well-organized neutral zone team right now, and I think they've done a good job of getting Neil Yakupov on a line with two veterans, Boulanger and Smith. And Yakupov's got some exciting game to him. He's got a good shot, good release, and he's a player that the Blues certainly will have to watch.
A shot into the glove of Dubnyk, and prior to joining the Oilers last year, Krueger spent 13 years as the head coach of the Swiss national team. He's coached in 3 Olympics and 12 world championships.
And got a chance to know Ralph during the Olympics and seeing what he did with the Swiss program. And he's well prepared to be a head coach in the NHL. They took a long time to decide last year where they were going to head in the offseason after Tom Rennie was let go. And even some whispers out there that they spoke with Mark Messier about the possibility of becoming a coach. But Ralph Krueger is your head coach in Edmonton.
Here's Kraftel, a turnaround shot, and Kraftel's shot tipped in the way through. Kraftel, 13 goals this year in Peoria.
He's got a good shot, and of course he's not the fastest player. He knows that, but he's always around the puck. He's smart with it. Good play to get it back to the point. He protects the puck well. He's 6'2", 210 pounds, and he does have some very good offensive instincts.
Again, his mom and dad, Pat and Pete, and Grandma Patricia watching tonight in Victoria, British Columbia.
You remember that journey they were on to see him play his first game at Joe Louis Arena? They had to fly from Victoria to Las Vegas to Mini to get to Detroit in time for the game, and he rifled one right off the pipe on his very first shift in the NHL. It was awesome.
But in 26 NHL games, has 4 goals and 8 points. Blues clear it back to center ice. And the former Blackhawk, Ben Eager, back to get it. He had a goal last night in their 5-1 win. Now Nick Schultz ahead. That's blocked, and Backes has some time and sends it in. Dubnyk to play it. Puts it on the glass. Kicked free by Backes. On the cycle, Backes in front. Rebound. And hammered away by Schwartz. And Dubnyk kept it out as the Blues went to the net with a vengeance there. And almost made a early dent in the twine behind Dubnyk.
Yeah, good job by Schwartz just to get there, get his nose dirty, get right into the blue paint on a good work down low by Oshie and Backes.
There's Schwartz again, a shot and a pass save by Dubnyk. Now Schwartz for Oshie. Schmid comes in number 5 along with Ryan Nugent-Hopkins. Blues get it back, and the pass by Oshie is tipped to center ice, and the Blues have to clear the zone. And then thrown back in by Bergman. Here's Perron off the bench. He gets to a loose puck. Chased by Nugent-Hopkins. Out high. Redden for Shattenkirk. 5:35 gone, first period. Shots are 5-0 for the Blues. Played by Taylor Hall. That goes high. And back into the Blues end.
It's a good play by Taylor Hall there. He's obviously an offensively gifted player. They're in trouble in their own zone, but he uses the glass and gets it out of play.
Now Bergman in for Redden. To the side of the goal, that's knocked away with the stick of Dubnyk. Oilers get the puck up the left wing side. Jones to center ice, but now Perron spins it back in behind his own goal. Recovered there by Pola.
Well, back-to-back good shifts, and that's what you want, is you want continuation, keeping the puck in deep and making sure you're all on the same page in that area.
And a shot by D'Agostini, and again another shot that gets through. As the Blues have just put a lot of pucks on net, they would love the first goal. Big first hit by Bergman. No score here in the first period.
Well, getting on the same page early on with a new left winger is essential for the captain, Dave Backes. And when you see the start here, here's Backes here. Now watch where he's going to end up on this play. So he supports it. The goaltender, Devan Dubnyk, plays it there. And now it's game on the cycle game. Very difficult to stop or eliminate Backus once he gets on that cycle. And then Jaden Schwartz has their Plaza Tire Service replay, shows it driving hard to the net. And this is going to be trouble all night long because Jaden Schwartz is trying to get around Justin Schultz with Nick Schultz on the doorstep.
Again, no relation. Justin Schultz was a sought-after free agent out of Wisconsin. Originally drafted by Anaheim, but never signed by the Ducks.
Yeah, that was a loophole in the system right there. You feel bad for Anaheim. They obviously anticipated that Justin Schultz was going to be part of their future. And in fact, at one point, they made a trade with the Toronto Maple Leafs, sending a young defenseman there. But Justin Schultz ends up from a handful of teams picking the Edmonton Oilers, and boy, is he an offensive phenom. He's got great instincts, and the Blues are going to have to really watch him. The winger's going to have their head on a swivel because he jumps in from the point position a lot.
Last year had 44 points in 37 games with Wisconsin. And here is Nick Schultz, former Wild defenseman.
The defenseman I was thinking of was Jake Gardner, that's now a Toronto Maple Leaf and once a first-round draft pick of Anaheim.
And that's an icy call.
Yeah, you would expect, in back-to-back nights, a bit of a slow start, especially for Edmonton. They're in no hurry to do anything. Their goaltender, Devan Dubnyk, covered a lot of loose pucks, and I'm sure the defenseman like Nick Schultz, the veteran, is telling him, let's not keep the play alive here. Let's shut it down and keep the crowd out of this game for as long as we can.
Yeah, it's been really cautious, more than quiet, I think. Very, very quietly cautious, maybe, is a better word.
Quietly cautious. I like that, Bernie.
Here comes Baron Jackman. Good hard pass to Backus.
He got drilled after that.
He moves in a shot. That got through, and a save by Dubnyk. As that was a pretty good hit behind the play by Petrell on Jackman.
Yeah, Leonard Petrell, number 37 of the Edmonton Oilers. He finished his check. Jackman, of course, made the outlet pass. And then as he's making the pass on the left side, he looks, and bang, shoulder to shoulder. Good hit right there by Petrell. And there's our Plaza Tire Service replay and the whip of the stick there of David Backus on that long shot. It's an easy save for the goaltender. I think Backus was looking for a juicier rebound than that.
Blues win the faceoff. Here is Redden. His wrist shot hit a body on the way through. Now Cracknell in behind the Oiler goal. And somebody, I believe, either a hand pass or a high stick. And they'll bring the faceoff to center ice.
Well, Ken Hitchcock showing a lot of confidence early on in this fourth line. And the key to this fourth line is not just getting the puck in deep and having a little bit of a rotation in the offensive zone, but being reliable in their own zone. You can ill afford to have your fourth line be a minus line or spend a lot of time inside their own zone. And so far in this game, I think Cracknell's really, looked good on this line.
Here's Shattenkirk. He's chased by Ben Eager. Nice play by Shattenkirk. On to Cracknell, hands it to Reeves. Then Reeves gets it deep. Cracknell after it against Big Jeff Petrie. Puck comes free. Shattenkirk. He activates in from the right point. Now back to Reeves. Across for Redden. Redden a shot, and that's tipped wide by Cracknell. And now Cracknell gets it again. And now we get an interference penalty, a bit of a pick. Set up in the corner by Reeves, and he'll go.
St. Louis 75 interference.
After a real good shift, moving the puck through the neutral zone, now Ken Hitchcock's squad is going to go on the penalty kill right there. He's definitely impeding the progress of Ladislav Smead and getting in on the puck. And Reeves is only trying to go to the open ice, open area to get maybe a reverse cycle right there, but instead he clearly does pick him. And now it's going to be power play for Edmonton, where they're 22.5% for the year.
Sixth best in the entire league. It's Whitney for Yakupov. First overall pick. There's Jones in front. First power play of the evening goes to the Oilers. Yakupov looks across, but Eberle is watched by Sobotka. And now back of the goal. It is Gagne right in front. Whitney a shot. That was blocked, I think, by the leg of Backus. And fired high by Backus, and that trickles down the ice.
Yakupov was going to get a delay of game penalty over on the far side. Bernie, I haven't seen a player hold on to the puck that long for a while.
And he was geeking himself, too. It was quite entertaining.
And you saw the numbers. The Blues have killed 10 in a row over their last four games. And 45 gone in the Reeves minor.
And you see the trust that Bradshaw has in Chris Porter as well. On the penalty kill, he did a good job in the American Hockey League and here last year.
Now Alex Hemsky, what a move, and a save by Halak. I believe he got his arm or shoulder on the shot by Hemsky, who has wicked hands. Now across, Hemsky again. Back for Justin Schultz. Schultz winds up, fires it, left pad, save by Halak. And then Pollock to the corner for Porter. And Chris Porter out-muscles an Oiler and clears it away.
Boy, you cannot get caught looking at the puck with Hemsky, that's for sure. Boy, did he ever give Roman the old nine of hearts right there with that nifty little toe drag.
Oh, banger. It was unbelievable.
Oh. And maybe off the goalpost as well. Now Justin Schultz. And a cross and a drive by Nugent Hopkins. Missed everything.
That's two good scoring chances that if indeed Hemsky's missed, and that one right there, those are two quality chances that they missed the net on.
Yeah, I thought Hemsky's was just up
over the
top of the net. Yeah, but what a move. Holy man.
it looked like a ball hockey game.
It was amazing.
Blues have killed it off. They allowed two shots on goal. It's still scoreless. Here's Stewart at the line now for Berglund. He'll twist one back of the goal. Reeves in a battle there with Schmid. And Reeves emerges for Petrangelo. The blast and a pad save by Dubnyk with a Berglund screen. I mean, he was right in Dubnyk's kitchen.
That was a smart play by Petrangelo. Eager doesn't get in the shooting lane. Petrangelo changes just a little bit, and he's able to get a good tough shot on goal.
Now moves on the attack. D'Agostini in deep for Perron. Here's one off the puck by Schmid. D'Agostini knocked a man down, got away with it. That was Petrie who gets up. 9:15 to go in the first period. Shot 8-2 for the Blues. And we're scoreless. Pollock's pass. And now recovered by Sobotka. Pollock tries the other side. That's tipped in there by Perron. Dubnyk will brush it back of the goal rather casually for Nick Schultz.
Yeah, I thought he was going to cover it up, and I think his defenseman did as well.
Hammered in by Hemsky. And the first man back is Wade Redden, who's been a healthy scratch for three straight. He takes Cole's spot in the lineup tonight. Now Shattenkirk. Tic-tac-toe into the zone. Tipped by Sobotka. Gagne back. Throws it off the boards and back to center ice. And rugby scrum near the Oiler bench. Blues get it. Backus. Schwartz to Oshie. Back to Backus, a drive, and a one-timer was just wide. And now Oshie to the line for Redden. That shot tipped just wide by Backus. And now for Schwartz. This line has shown some early chemistry. First ever appearance in the game. Redden a shot, and again it's blocked in front. And then a cross-check by Gagne, and that will be called. As he cross-checked Schwartz to the ice. And the Blues will operate on the power play in a scoreless game.
Real good give and go there with this all WCHA college line. And Jaden Schwartz looking good so far. They're feeding off one another. Backus plays it back to Redden. Redden twice in this game. He's had a good job of getting it through, but that one blocked by Gagne. Doesn't seem like much, that little nudge. Two of the smaller players in the game, but Jaden Schwartz doesn't embellish it. But obviously your skates are rockered, so anytime you get pushed from behind, you're going to fall forward. And that one didn't seem like much, and I know that Gagne was frustrated, but he puts a cross-check in on him from behind.
Those power plays struggling of late, 0 for the last 13. But they remain second best in the league at 28.8%. Here's Oshie. Fans on a pass. Oilers get it, and they clear it. The Oilers on the kill, very good. Fourth best, 87.4%.
That's not unlike the always reliable TJ Oshie with that kind of play. A simple play, moving it to his right, just rolled off his blade.
Now Petrangelo in for Oshie. He'll drop it off for Perron. Sets up on the half boards into Oshie. Flips it back for Petrangelo. Thought about shooting. Now a wrist shot. Hit by Backus. Not a lot of mustard on that one. Oilers shoot it around the glass. And it trickles to center ice.
And keep in mind, the Blues are without three players on their second power play unit, with still Tarasenko out, and obviously Steen and Andy McDonald.
Now Perron trying to drop pass. Instead, drags the puck back to the right point on this Blues power play. To the front for Petrangelo. To Shattenkirk. Bruce had too many men there and really got away with it.
They had too many men for like an extended period
of time. Sobotka was at the blue line, skated off, and there were five other guys on the ice. And now we get a whistle.
Well,
now he called the too many men, guys.
Yeah, but how did he call it this late?
I don't know. Maybe he heard you guys.
No, there were still six. Stewart was still on the ice.
St. Louis bench minor for too many men on the ice.
It happened twice. Am I not mistaken? Bernie, I think it happened twice. So here we go with one, two, three, four, five, and six in front of the net. That was the first time. Now watch Sobotka as this rolls along. Sobotka says, oh, we got too many men on the ice. Watch it. He goes off the ice. There's no call here. The play went on now for an extended period of time. Came back out again, and they did another line change here.
Yeah, two came on there for the one change, so there was. It did happen twice.
We were talking to Hitchcock the other day after practice, and the Blues, in the past couple of weeks, have had three bench minors for too many men on the ice on improper changes after special teams. And this was during a power play, not after the power play. And as you said, they did it twice.
Unbelievable.
So we go 4-on-4. Here comes Oshie. And he lost his speed, and the Oilers get it back. And Eric Bélanger. Now picked up by Redden. In 10 seconds, Gagne returns, and the Oilers go back on the power play. Shattenkirk now for Sobotka. 2-on-2. Trying to go wide against Justin Schultz. Now Sobotka. And a man cutting. That was Petrangelo. Now he gets it to him. The shot. And it was blocked out high. And it comes near the goal and swatted away by Dubnyk. Now the Oilers in the power play for the second time tonight. As Gagne gains the line for Yakupov. Under pressure from Petrangelo when he gives it up.
Good pressure there by Petrangelo. And David Backus knew exactly where Yakupov was going to put it, and he picked it off easily.
And a shot by Backus. Floats wide. Scott Nickel back of the goal. And creates some havoc behind the Oilers goal. And now it comes ahead for Yakupov. To Eberle. He is a superb playmaker, as Eberle. The Blues break it up, and again it goes down the ice.
Yeah, Eberle's got some really good hands, but he's not a guy usually that does what he just did right there, and that is, while with the man advantage, trying to one-on-one a player right inside the blue line.
Now 22 to go in the power play. Long stretch pass for Hemsky. He'll tip it back to the goal. And Chatford gets there. Oilers recover to the line, and Whitney cannot hold it in.
Boy, Whitney's been a storm of controversy and conversation with how often he's been scratched, a healthy scratch. Five of the last seven games, including the last four.
And now the Blues have killed it off. No Oilers shots. They're 0 for 2. And Oshie has it. He doesn't clear it. Nugent Hopkins kept it in.
Berglund's stick was broken. He's trying to use his skates to push it over towards him.
Now it is Petrie. His shot. And that was blocked by Oshie. And the Blues get it back. They've outshot the Oilers 8-2. But we're scoreless. Oshie now for Berglund. And he gets the red line and sends it in. Last year, the Blues won 3 of 4 against the Oilers, winning both at home. As a matter of fact, they've won the last 5 at Scott Trade against Edmonton.
Yeah, 9-2 in the last 11.
Now Justin Schultz, rather casual pass there, picked off. Perron snaps it back in. Dubnyk can't stop it. And then run around the far board by Petrie. Oilers to center. Bélanger now for Justin Schultz. Angles one to the corner. Here is Leonard Petrell, number 37. He's run off the puck by Jackman. Stewart has it, can't clear it. Now Petrell back of the goal.
That's a big body right there.
Chased by Jackman. Turned over, and Stewart up the middle. And he's got a partial break. And a shot, and it goes just high as he had to hurry the shot. He did good speed there.
Great job of pushing the puck ahead, getting it the last second. No, he's not going to be able to stick handle or bring it back on his blade very much. And he just flicks it just high over the blocker side.
Now the Blues. After the change, Adam Cracknell is after it along with Reeves. 3 minutes left here in the opening period. Nickel trying to hold it in. He can't. And now recovered at center by the veteran Nickel. Oh, that shot from Nickel on the dump-in may have hit Cracknell up high. And we get a whistle on that offside. Under three to play. Opening period. Blues and Oilers are scoreless. No score late in the first period. Let's head downstairs between the benches for this Bomberito Automotive Update.
Well, Panger, you talked about Chris Stewart, about how smart it was. Just use your one hand, push the puck forward. That's a lot of times you don't need a stick handle, and certainly Chris Stewart shows this here. Just getting the puck, look at, just using the one hand, stretching out, and then getting a good shot away. Unfortunately, it went up over top of the net, but good work. You don't always have to stick handle the puck. You can push it ahead. As long as you get there quicker than the defenseman, you're in good shape.
You can skate a lot faster if you don't stick handle, right, Bernie?
Yes, you can.
As Hitch said last year, you can't dust off the puck all the time.
Here's Taylor Hall, a pass in front, tip, rebound, and Schultz, I believe, knocked it in. Or somebody, Hall was there as well, and the Oilers take a 1-0 lead.
It was a left-handed Hall sniffing around right there. He's got the long stick, and he was going to his right. The puck squirted back to his left, and Taylor Hall clearly snapped this one in to the blocker side of Yaro Halak. Scramble in front of the net. The Edmonton Oilers do a good job of fighting off on the corner. But look at the support. The battle's there, but there's two Oilers right there. And here comes Justin Schultz, as I talked about. Moves up in the play, starts that up after the forward support of the puck on the far side. And here's the very end of it here. Justin Schultz is there, but it's going to be the stick right coming up there. And it's through the legs of Justin Schultz, and Taylor Hall snaps this one home.
His fourth of the year, first in five games. The goal at 17:30.
Well, suspended for two games for that knee and incident against Minnesota's Cal Clutterbuck. I nearly screwed that up.
I didn't know where you were going with that one. Here's Whitney, a shot, he scores! Two quick goals, and Ryan Whitney is first of the year, and it's 2-0.
Teams are getting chances on the rush against the St. Louis Blues that are normally prided themselves on being a great team defending through the neutral zone. Well, that's not the case here. And this place is as quiet as I've heard it in an awful long time. But behind the net, the Blues now have got three forwards in deep, but now it's still a two-on-two. Stop it here if we can. And here's the man here beating the forward. Let it roll, and that's going to be Whitney. Takes a perfect pass there and just snaps it home to the stick side. So three men in deep, the third man not high in the offensive zone, had a chance to backtrack hard against Whitney, does not, and Whitney ends up being the goal scorer.
Two goals in 23 seconds. Whitney's first, and first goal going back to last year in 26 games. And the Oilers, just like that, despite getting outshot 8-5, lead 2-0. And that has got to be demoralizing for the Blues.
That is throwing the monkey off your back for Whitney. That's been a healthy scratch, and certainly the conversation of trade suggestions.
Blues fire it down the ice with 90 seconds left in the first period. Schmid fires one off the far wall. Covered now by Russell. So Hall and Whitney scored 23 seconds apart. And Backes, he'll twist one into the Oilers zone. And on the forecheck is Schwartz. But the Oilers get to it, and Sam Gagne works one to center ice. Now Hemsky, oh, into Jones, who's behind the Blues defense. And again, an outnumbered attack there for Edmonton. Final minute here in the first period. Oilers back on the line for Schultz. And a shot by Justin Schultz. That was blocked. Quickly now to Backes. He moves through the neutral zone. Now Backes to the front. Petrangelo in the area, but it was knocked away. And now the Oilers and Hemsky's around Perron. Carves a break. And a save by Halak on a breakaway by Hemsky.
Good save with 2D up in the play. David Perron, the lone man back, and he gets beat to the puck by Hemsky, the tricky forward. Good save by Halak.
And now Sam Gagne, that drive back against the grain and a save by Halak.
These are quality scoring chances that the Edmonton Oilers are getting. Well, Bernie, you'd like a handful of those, wouldn't you? Going left to right or right to left in the high slot?
This is just getting way too scrambly. I mean, the Blues really now all of a sudden lost their composure, and now all of a sudden the floodgates are opening.
Here's Taylor Hall, drop pass, and that will do it. So the Blues played pretty well for the majority of that period, but the Oilers get two late goals. Hall from Eberle and Schultz And then Whitney from Smith and Yakupov, 2 goals in 23 seconds.
Well, we saw that last night against the Chicago Blackhawks, 12 seconds in, and a goal being scored on the rush from the defensive zone of Chicago right to the goal melt scramble that was scored by Taves. And here we've seen it, an explosion of sorts for consecutive shifts by Edmonton, and that's a big save right there by Halak.
So it's 2-0 after one. Let's go to Jim Hayes.
All right, a couple of goals in a span of 23 seconds, and the Blues are down 2-0 after one period of play. Here's what's coming up in the SayPod GM Country Intermission Report. We'll check out our Bud Light What's on Tap. We'll look ahead at the Blues' upcoming schedule. They're on the road for five straight. We'll take a look at high school hockey. CBC and SLU High are set to battle for all the marbles. Plus, we'll check in with Bernie Federko as well. We'll get Bernie's take on the first period of play. Right now, Blues in a bit of a hole. They're down 2-0. Oilers lead it after one period of play. Back with the intermission report after this. You're watching Blues Hockey on Fox Sports Midwest.
With the first six shots on goal in the opening period, but Jared, they can't find the back of the net, and then they give up two goals on the rush late in the period at 23 seconds, and they're down by two.
Yeah, they're looking for that break early on. They had a couple of good chances from the point, and Devin Dubnyk made a couple of good saves, especially through traffic on those points, but obviously in transition, the Blues have got to do a better job of defending the rush. It's happening far too often, and obviously, you need that third man high. You need that third man coming back hard. The Blues last year established themselves as one of the toughest teams in terms of back checking. But we have a moment right now as the linesman's fixing up the crease of Devin Dubnyk for our first bank, first take. And here are the Edmonton Oilers and the high draft picks. Neil Yakupov obviously had an assist in that period. Nugent Hopkins was first overall in 11. Taylor Hall, first overall in 2010. Pjärvi, Eberle, and Gagne also high picks that have developed into good players. Pjärvi, a healthy scratch for this game.
And a shot by Hall is off the side of the goal. Blues Hockey brought to you by Bud Light. It's the sure sign of a good time. Here we go. Underway in the second period. Oilers with a 2-0 lead. Pass to center for Eberle. And that's played back in, and it's offside. Well, Card spring training is underway, and Fox Sports Midwest is bringing you more coverage than ever. We'll have an all-time high of 10 spring training games starting March 14th, and the season preview report starting March 17th. Card spring training coverage brought to you by Fairmount Park is on Fox Sports Midwest. There's Dubnyk. Plays one to the far side. Juan is in on the forecheck along with Stewart. And Berglund, the other member of that forward line. Now Berglund out near the line. He gets away from a man. And a drive, got through, and a save by Dubnyk. And then Stewart put the rebound wide. And the Blues after it. Stewart comes up with it. Out near the line. Now to the corner for Perron. And Perron worked over by Petrie. And then Berglund and Gagne engage in a battle. Now Perron spins, trying to find an opening. Here's Perron, wanders out high, takes a spot of Shattenkirk, fires it back of the goal for Berglund. Good offensive shift here by the Blues. Berglund in front, and a shot by Shattenkirk. Hit a leg on the way through. And now Chris Porter gets free back of the goal. Now Porter to the front. And Hemsky stripped him of the puck off the boards, but kept in by Sobotka. And now Porter. The Oilers have not had a change in the Blues now with their second offensive group on the shift. D'Agostini a drive. And a save by Dubnyk. And they get the whistle with a big scramble in front.
Well, when you're 6'5 like Devin Dubnyk is, you're able to cover a lot of real estate, even going down on that loose puck right there. That was a minute and 16 seconds of zone time in the offensive zone for the St. Louis Blues. It's something we became accustomed to last year, was one line after another keeping the puck in deep and making it difficult. Ladislav Schmid falls awkwardly on his goaltender. Some good puck support there. Berglund strips the puck, and now he's in a pretty good spot. Fires it in there, just gets through right there in the rebound, but there's Wade Redden on the doorstep. By that point, the third man high in the offensive zone went for a line change. Sobotka comes off the ice, and they keep that rotation going, giving the Edmonton Oilers plenty of fits in their own zone to begin this second period.
And now Sobotka will take the faceoff. He is between D'Agostini and Porter. Faceoffs were dead even in that first period. And Belanger, a very good faceoff in, wins it for Edmonton. And then chipped in by Ryan Smith. Here's the lock up the far side. And then Belanger steps in, back on the line. Hammered to the corner by Theo Peckham. And now Russell gets it away from Smith. And Chris Russell to center ice. That's off the glass and now into the netting, and they'll break the faceoff to center ice.
Not bad break there for the Blues as they get the puck in deep. It hits the top of the dashboard, comes up over top of the glass, and then into the netting. And we'll see what...
There seems to be a lot more jump banger in this period. I don't know what was said after the first period, but certainly there's a lot more jump, a lot more energy on the bench right now.
And I would think, Bernie, and you know, you and I are just experienced of being in that situation before, that it's not a coach that comes in and likely says something after that period. It's the players' ownership group in that room.
Yep.
You would think that sparks the debate, where the coaches pitch back and says, are they saying the right things in there? And if they are, just let them say it.
Now the Oilers on a man rush. Petrell in with Whitney. And Petrell a shot, and he whistled that one high. On a two-on-one. And now Cracknell deep in his own zone. Redden for Shattenkirk. And then back to center ice. Shot around by Cracknell. In on the forecheck against Justin Schultz. Centers it, can play it back as a drive. And a save by Dubnyk.
Well, that's a wicked snapper there by David Backes. And it was right in line under the bar and in. But Dubnyk just comes out. Another first-round draft pick of the Edmonton Oilers, who is now blossoming into a number one. Good pressure there by Cracknell getting in there on Schultz. And then a nifty little backhand pass by Adam Cracknell. And the more he plays like this, the more he's going to get on the ice.
And a shot by Jackman. That hurt Taylor Hall.
Oh, did it ever.
He goes off. And he off the hand as Backes gets the puck to the corner. Shot around by Nick Schultz, and the Oilers do tip it away.
And Hall got that right in the, it was upper arm, like almost the shoulder, John. Right above the elbow, I think. So he was hurt.
It was a blocker save, huh?
Yeah, without moving the arm. Yeah. It was a natural blocker shot.
Now it is Sam Gagne on the back check. Schwartz breaks it up for the Blues, have numbers into the zone. On for Oshie, cuts in a shot. Schwartz a drive, he scores!
The Blues take advantage of a turnover by Hemsky inside the blue line of the Blues zone. That turnover means the Blues go the other way. And Backes with a nifty little saucer pass over to Oshie. I thought Oshie was going to play it to the far side on the oncoming defenseman on the weak side, but he chose to shoot it. And Jaden Schwartz takes advantage. Here on the pull-up, the shot gets blocked, and it goes right on the tape to Schwartz, who just rips it past the goaltender. So Jaden Schwartz gets added to this top line. He's got his billets from when he played in Nebraska in the USHL. They're here on hand tonight to watch their billeted son, as you might add, before he went over to Colorado College. And it's a big goal for Jaden Schwartz.
Big goal for second of the year.
His confidence is strong. Play like this, we stop it here. He's the late man right here, so keep your eye on that player there, Jaden Schwartz. It's blocked, his stick's on the ice, so he doesn't take his stick off the ice, and in one belt swoop, he just rifles it home. Good hand-eye coordination by Schwartz.
He gets it from Oshie and Backes at 3:38. And that cuts the Oilers' lead to 2-1. And shots 4-0 Blues in the second period. Now Perron to Russell. On for Stewart. hits the Oiler line. He'll chip it by Schmid, and then back of the goal for Perron. Leaves it for Bergman. And then tipped on to Stewart. Stewart centers it, but the Oilers break it up. Good job there by Jeff Petrie. And here come the Oilers. Yakupov, 4-on-3. Yakupov pulls up to the front of shot. Up in the air, and that's gloved by Halak. And he melts it down for the whistle.
Well, we've seen the Blues do this, and I know it's frustrated the players and the coaches, turning the puck over just inside the blue line, and Hemsky's got it there, and you see the backside pressure by Schwartz. He starts it off by hounding Hemsky, and then it goes the other way. So Schwartz starts it off defensively, and then he ends up capitalizing on the goal that makes it 2-1.
Good work in the defensive zone usually leads to good work in the offensive zone. And the Blues finally get a break there for a change, too, as that puck bounced right to Schwartz.
What does it, Hinch, like to say? You've got to check the score.
Yep.
Yeah. Now, Crackle. To the line. Shattenkirk a shot. Uh-oh. Off Eager, and Eager's off to the races. Look out! Hit a lock. Gambles and wins. Oh! Halak came up large there. He beat Eager to the puck. He gets a stick back.
He looked like Dominic Hasek coming out of the net like that. Good stuff.
He barely beat Eager to that puck. And that got the crowd into it here.
I haven't seen Yarrow skate that fast.
He's got pretty good wheels. Look out here. Jordan Eberle with it. And the backhander goes wide as the Blues get sloppy here. And now Redden up the middle. And this goes all the way down. It will go on net, so no icing.
Well, those are exciting moments as a goaltender. Really, if you hesitate at all, you've got to stay back. But if you're on your toes and you read it right away, then you can go. But I've been embarrassed a ton of times by making the wrong gamble there.
Great pass by Jackman into Schwartz and a backhander and fought off by Dubnyk. Kept in by Petrangelo. And his shot, hit a leg, goes out of play off Taylor Hall. And we'll get a face-off in the Oilers' end.
That old saying, when in doubt, get out. Well, for this kind of play here, Yaro Halak's got a decision here. Am I going or am I staying right here? And he decides to go for the long poke check on Ben Eager, number 55, trying for it. And then good hand-eye coordination by Shattenkirk to bat it out in midair. Cracknell then swipes his stick right back to him, and it's off to the races. Pretty exciting moment right there.
Well, Shattenkirk was helping him out after he toe-picked himself there.
At the boards right by you, huh?
Yes, because there's no way Ben Eager's going to beat anybody to a puck unless you fall down. And that's exactly what happened.
Kevin's dad, Pat Shattenkirk, is in the house tonight, as he was last night watching his son play over the weekend.
Papa Shatty, huh?
Really nice man. That goes out of play. 14:05 left.
His Twitter handle
the second period.
Pop Shat Deuces.
Well, it's March 1st, so that means madness for college basketball. But before the big dance begins, check out Missouri Valley Conference Tournament action once again. It will be held at Scott Trade March 7th to 10th. And individual game or all session tickets are on sale now at the Ford box office. And the Oilers step into the circle after that faceoff. Here comes Hemsky in with Jones, and a shot by Hemsky hit the leg and went wide of the goal. Off the boards, Porter trying to get there with Sobotka. 2-on-1 now. It's Sobotka to Porter, and the pass was elevated, and Porter couldn't knock it down. That was a hard pass to handle. And Gagne back in for Hemsky. Jackman blocked the pass, and then brushed along by Petrangelo. Oilers pinching, they get caught again. And the Blues, Porter in for Sobotka. In front, and he was turned the wrong way and couldn't get it from his skate to his stick.
Two plays there, one by Sobotka over to Porter. Originally, it was just too high for him. If he had a lacrosse stick, he could have handled that first one, and then that one there was just behind him. So two pretty good opportunities squandered, but good speed going towards Edmonton's net.
Maybe too many men, Bernie. I believe we got a call from the linesman down there. Schwartz is second. Has cut the Oilers lead to 2.
It looked like you guys controlled most of this first period, and then you give up a couple of quick goals. What did you tell the guys after the first period?
Well, we got to keep doing the things we're doing well, but we can't get beat back up the ice. They've got some odd man rushes because we've tried to be a little bit too on our toes with F3, and they burn us a couple times. So we're going to get scoring chances if we just stay disciplined with our third forward.
Thanks, Hitch.
And the Blues get another bench binder for too many men. Oilers 0 for 2 tonight. I thought at first it was against Edmonton, but the Blues was 1-2. Get nailed for another bench binder. That's the fifth in the last 7 games. Hard to believe.
At 6:41,
backdoor feed for Nugent Hopkins off his leg and out of play.
Well, let's go back to it again and just see exactly how obvious it is with this too many men on the ice at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and that is 6 right there on the ice, in the middle of the ice. It's not even a line change. There has got to be some giddy up and go on that bench and some alertness and communication.
Well, there's got to be a problem with the line changes. When the line changes so often are happening, there's got to be, as you said, lack of communication, because everybody's told who's going for who, and I'm shocked that this could happen. And actually, it's the third time it happened, Panger, because it was the last time it happened. They had twice that they were had too many men on the ice.
That'll Blues shorthanded, but Berglund goes just offside. And that too many men was just as egregious, if not worse, than the one in the first period. I mean, it's not even close near that bench.
Nope, not even close. You've got to be sharp on that bench. Obviously, the coach's job is to direct traffic, is to be clear and concise and let everybody know who's on the ice. And the players have to be sharp. But that wasn't... these aren't even close calls.
So the Oilers 0 for 2 in the power play.
I get the Blues are struggling scoring goals, but you can't trick these referees with adding to the extra man on without calling your goalie.
Sam Gagne backhand from the corner. Pollock back there, but Gagne was on his own side of center ice. So icy call.
You know, it's interesting, guys, on that last too many men on the ice, this penalty here, it was three defensemen were on the ice. I mean, and that's really should never happen, because you know what, it's pairs. The guys are in pairs. It's not that it's three guys on a line.
And the Blues are playing so well here in the second, out shooting the Oilers 5-0.
That's the way you defend them, Bernie. You throw 3D out there.
Okay. The waters are rough, Panger.
Take it on water.
Get the sail down right now.
Here comes Ryan Whitney. He scored the Oilers' second goal. Sabot gets center ice. Steps in front of Whitney, now grabbed by Yakupov. And he pulls up on the half court. Drops it off to Whitney. And then Yakupov again. He goes back to the left point now for Everly. In for Gagne. Jones screens in front. There's Gagne with 20 to go on the power play. Everly out of the corner. Gagne looks in front to Jones. Shot and a save by Halak. And it goes off his stick and out of play.
Good save there by Yaro Halak. Pushing from his post to the top of the crease. Getting his stick on that one. They were looking for Yakupov to Yaro's left. Yakupov right here, a left-hand shot. This is what they're looking for there, but there's no option, so they play it to Jones. So good alternative there on that nifty little pass by Gagne. So you have two options right there, the backdoor play to the one-timer to Yakupov, or you've got Jones right there in the front of the net. Pretty good scoring chance.
Now, you know, I think the defenseman, which would have been Shattenkirk there, has got to go down with that puck carrier quicker, Panger. You can't let the guy set up there and have two options. You're one with Pollock's taking away the one option to slide through through the crease, but you got to get to that guy as quick as you can.
Wilson killed it off. They allowed one shot on that power play. And still trail 2-1. Now Petrangelo for Stewart. He'll scoop it in. He goes after it. And Stewart rolls back of the goal now to the line, and the Oilers break it up, and here they come. And the speedy Taylor Hall. And run to the inboards by Pollock, picked up by Everly. And Schmid had to contend with a bouncing puck.
And that puck just exploded on him right inside the blue line. Boy, that Taylor Hall goes into dangerous areas fast, doesn't he? He went in there on the inside of Roman Pollock and just got his edges there before going skates first into the boards.
Yeah, he's not afraid at all. And after taking that shot in the arm, too, I'm surprised that he's back this quickly, too.
Now Petrell, number 37, that pass, hit a stick, goes to Schwartz, he moves in, Jaden Schwartz, a shot, and a save by Dubnyk, as Schwartz almost had a second, and then he's buried in the corner, and a penalty coming up here, as Schwartz is down, the Blues come in, they did not like that hit, and the arm went up, and now the Blues Trainer Ray Borelli is out there.
Ray Borelli got out there awfully fast because it's everyone's always certainly concerned when you're facing the boards and you end up getting drilled into the boards right there. Schwartz just has a great scoring chance, so they'll be careful in getting Jaden Schwartz off for a line change there. Here's Schwartz coming in now with the puck. So a quick little shot going to the short side. Now he turns and spins. Let's see if he turns at the last second. He kind of does. He's going one way and then makes a little turn. Keep your eye on this here. Going one way here. Now he turns. And by that time, Schmid is committed to his hit and is leaning into him in the, you know, from behind. And it's not a violent push, but Schwartz is trying to turn on a dime. I'm not sure what else Ladislav Schmid could do right there.
Yeah, that really was played harmless, too.
Yeah.
There was no way that he was going to get hurt on that either. He was just going to push.
Polak got caught on a very similar play a few games ago. And a boarding call to Schmid. The Blues get their second power play. Trailing 2-1. Hall and Whitney have scored for the Oilers. Schwartz for the Blues.
Now D'Agostini in for Sobotka. He works in a shot.
And the right arm of Dubnyk got up in time. Now Sobotka back for Shattenkirk.
In tight. Stewart. Sobotka back to Shattenkirk. He scores! Shattenkirk. And even tipped, and it's 2-2.
D'Agostini was in the high slot with Vladdy Sobotka handling the half boards on the left. So without Steen, Tarasenko, and Andy McDonald, it's a change. There's the shot, and there's the redirection, maybe by D'Agostini, or maybe it goes off the defenseman Petrie. Oh, beautiful super slow-mo angle there. Here it is here. Nope, it doesn't look like it hits D'Agostini. I think it hits the defenseman Petrie. But it sneaks by the goaltender, Devan Dubnyk, and we have got a tie game.
And the Blues break an 0-for-14 drought on the power play. Their first power play goal in six games, and it ties it at 2, the goal at 10:30. From that last hook, it'll be Shattenkirk's goal, the second. Now Reeves into the zone. Shattenkirk does get the goal. Here are the Oilers 3-on-2. Hemsky works in. Hemsky goes wide. Chased by Jackman to Sam Gagne. Now in for Justin Schultz. Right through the goal crease area. And then kept in at the left point by Nick Schultz. Sobotka and Stewart get the assist on that power play goal.
Shattenkirk assisted by Sobotka and
Stewart. And the Blues have fought back from the 2-0 deficit.
Well, for Shattenkirk, when you look at it, his 16 points, the most through 20 games since Al McGinnis at 17 and 0-1-0-2. But we'll keep our eye on the front of the net as Stewart now lays it back to Sobotka. The high man is D'Agostini, and it doesn't look like it nibbles off the heel of his blade. It looks like it goes off the right skate of Petrie by the goaltender. Good hard shot by Shattenkirk, who continues to find the net from the point position.
And that did appear to hit the right foot of Petrie. Well, the Billikens take on George Washington tomorrow at 3 o'clock on Fox Sports Midwest Plus. For channel listings, go to foxsportsmidwest.com. And there's Blues general manager Doug Armstrong. And his club with two goals in the second, Schwartz and Shattenkirk, and they fought back to tie it.
Always exciting games playing against the Edmonton Oilers. The Blues have had some pretty good comebacks along the way, including that great game last year by Petrangelo. And now it's back to being a hockey game right here. Keep in mind a couple of saves that Yaro Halak made, that race for the puck on Eager, and also the save on the power play where Jones has it right in the slot.
Now it's Yakupov into the zone for Belanger. Chip one to the corner. And now grabbed by the Blues, Wade Redden. Shots in the game, 16-8 for the Blues. And Berglund. He'll send it all the way back to the goal. Dubnyk plays it high on the dasher, and this will squirt to center ice. And then Berglund back for Redden. Shot to the period, 8-1 for the Blues. Now Redden, far side, bounced over the stick of Oshie, and played by Peckham. Changing the puck to center, and then gobbled up by Petrangelo. His pass blocked, and a 3-on-1 into the zone. Everly, the Hall, right in, and a diving play by Petrangelo to break it up. As he atoned for his own error, and now Schwartz in for the Blues. That shot, hit a stick, goes to the corner, picked up by Backes. Back to Petrangelo. On to Schwartz. Schwartz a drive, and a blocker saved by Dubnyk.
Boy, Schwartz has got a good release, doesn't he? You can tell that he's got a confident player.
Here's Ben Eager again. And a backhander, Halak handles that. Eager's got pretty good speed down the right side there.
Sign of a great player, though, when you cough up the puck like Petrangelo did trying to go to the backhand, you don't quit on the play. He got himself right back in, and he's able to nullify a 3-on-1 break.
Now, Chris Van de Velde, number 54, broken up by Russell, and he's off to the races. Here's Chris Russell. He'll filter one of the corner for Sobotka. Oilers have it, but Russell kept it in. And now it is muscled to center ice. Russell again steps up, then is hit by Van de Velde. And back to the Blues line. Then Poloff. He lost the battle with Van de Velde. With under 6:40 to go in the second period. Russell, long stretch pass for D'Agostini. He waits. He's got the big shot. Lets it go. And that was blocked by Peckham. And now Gagner back to center ice. 3-on-2. Whitney gets the drop pass to Jones. A shot, and that may have hit a body in the way through.
Boy, Whitney's been good at jumping into the play, hasn't he? Made some good plays. Scored a goal in this game. There he makes a nice pass and another excellent save by Jaro Halak.
And again, has been a healthy scratch for the last four straight. Here comes Schmid the other way. In for Gagner. Oilers leading scorer with 19 points. But Nickel for Reeves, tipped along now to Cracknell. And Cracknell at the line, and he makes the safe play. Reeves in on the forecheck. But Hemsky emerges from the corner. And kept in there by Nickel. A good back pressure there by Scott Nickel. And Schmid will slow it down for the Oilers. Blues wrapping up a three-game homestand. And they begin a five-game road trip Sunday afternoon in Dallas. 2 o'clock start. Melange at the line, lost it. Perron gets it back for the Blues. In for Stewart. He goes wide and a shot. Big rebound to Berglund. And Dubnyk made the save as Berglund with a pretty good rebound attempt there.
Yeah, pretty good shot from a sharp angle for Stewart actually to have that go off the pad perfectly. And you got your
turned over Yakupov, and he blasted that one wide as Berglund couldn't handle that hot pass in front of his own goal.
That was from the forward team there for Yakupov. Wow.
Was it ever?
That was a nice Pro V1 X right there, wasn't it, Bernie?
Yeah, I don't have too much spin on the X1.
And he had the wedge instead of the 3-iron, and it shot it high. Now the Blues to center Backes. He was stripped. And Everly comes in for Edmondson. Everly a shot, and that was wide by a couple of feet. Off the boards, this game really opens up. And now Backes. Too far for Schwartz. Oshie thought Schwartz was going to get there.
Yeah, Oshie didn't want to get caught. He wanted to be the third man high. Schwartz thought Oshie was going to take it.
And now Poloff steps in to Schwartz. To Oshie, a drive, and he put that one high. Now in the slot, Oshie with it. And off his skate to the stick, but he lost the handle. And now Ben Eager in the corner, end of the referee. Schwartz gets it back to the Blues. Deep slot for Sobotka. And then back for Shattenkirk. To D'Agostini. Rolls it in deep now for Sobotka. In a 2-2 game. Sobotka on the cycle. Here's D'Agostini, a shot. That didn't get through. And then Porter jams it back in the goal to D'Agostini. Looking for some open space. Now for Sobotka. Can't muscle in front.
Good support there by Porter.
Now Porter for D'Agostini. Throws it back on the goal again. Sobotka, plenty of time. He's in Federko's spot behind the net there. Using the net as the decoy. Players don't do that enough, do they, Bernie?
No, they don't.
No, they
need
don't.
To dump that to the front of the net, though.
Back on the line now to Shattenkirk. His shot doesn't get through.
I'm getting dizzy watching these guys cycle it into the boards. Bernie, we got to put the net in the corner.
And there's zero shots on goal. A lot of offensive zone time, but nothing to the net.
Yeah, a lot of good support. And getting the puck down deep and tiring out Edmonton, which is the key for that line. They did a good job, with led by Sobotka.
Under three to play here in the second period. Blues have scored both goals in this period. Outshot the Oilers 11-3. Now Bergman for Petrangelo. Stretch pass for Perron. Handed on to Jackman. And that goes around the inboards. Controlled by Gagne. Back for Peckham. Pass tipped along by Ryan Jones. And now the Blues get it back in here to center ice. Back is for Oshie. He wanders in. Oshie, little head fake. And then chased to the inboards by Sam Gagne.
Gagne did a good job on him defensively right there. He read that play, and Oshie ran out of real estate.
Now Whitney, one hands it back to the goal. Red in there for the Blues. And around to Backus, not cleared. And Ryan Smith picks it up. Here is Smith, the 37-year-old, for Yakupov. Out high, Petrie across for Schmid. Looking for the bank play, comes in front. And the Blues in the right spot. Schwartz now to center ice for Backus. And late on a shift, he'll dump it in.
Good position there by Schwartz. He didn't go chasing and running around. The puck ends up right on his tape, moves it right over to Backus, and they're out of their zone.
Schwartz has looked pretty comfortable on that top line tonight. Would you agree?
Yeah, absolutely. I think he's had the most jump in his step that I've seen in a while from him. I think he feeds off one another. And the one thing that has been talked about is he's a left-hand shot. And if for David Backus, that enables, you know, a guy going forward and putting the puck instead of behind him in front of him.
Now Reeves, he wins a foot race. Reeves back for Pollock. Long shot. Hit Nickel on the way through. Now back of the goal. Cracknell. Makes a good play back for Russell. And Russell's shot was elevated too high. And the Oilers up the middle now for Jordan Eberle in the final minute here. On for Nugent Hopkins to Eberle. Hard shot. And a save by Halak. He bobbles it a bit, but then covers it. 53 to go in the period. Shattenkirk has tied it, his first goal in a dozen games. It's 2-2. Well, fans, as you know, tonight is Pink at the Rink night. Each summer, the 14th Fund and Fox Sports Midwest partner to sponsor one of the event's largest teams. And as part of the event, team members and breast cancer survivors sign a banner, which tonight is placed right behind the Blues bench. And thanks to all of you for your continued support. And I have a chance to help out in that event every summer. And in our team, the Blues in Midwest, it gets bigger every year, Darren.
Yeah, it does. And Fox Sports Midwest, they do a phenomenal job. But man, why wouldn't everybody? Someone close to you, someone you know, has been affected by this dreadful disease. So whatever you do to chip in and help out along the way.
Now the Blues in this 2-2 game. Oh, it's just offside. Boy, that looked pretty good to me from here. Ooh, but they ruled it was offside.
It was close. I'm always amazed at these linesmen and how good they are. And for the limited amount of mistakes that these linesmen end up making, it gets so magnified, because generally speaking, it results in a goal against or something like that. But boy, they are sharp and they're on it. And you see with that whistle that Ken Hitchcock throws out Backus, Oshie, and Schwartz with 38 seconds to go in the period.
And the Blues control the faceoff. Here is Schwartz. And he was turned away by Peckham. Eberle back the other way for Edmonton. Puck in front, but Jackman with it for the Blues. Now Backus ahead for Schwartz. Out of Colorado College is Jaden Schwartz. Dude, to the far side, Backus on the forecheck. Now gets some help from Oshie. Here's Oshie back of the goal. He comes in front. Back to Jackman. Jackman to the front. Schwartz backhander. And a save by Dubnyk. Now Oshie again. Five to go in the period. Blues can't center it. And that will do it. And a superb second period for the Blues.
Yep. Good start by Jaden Schwartz, doing a great job on that line with Backus and Oshie. He scored his second, and then Shattenkirk pounded one home on the power play. Sobotka getting the helper. And this game all tied up at two.
Shots in that second period, 11-4 for the Blues. And after two periods, they've outshot the Oilers 19-11. Let's head over to the Bud Light Zone in Jim Higgs.
Yeah, guys, this place went from real quiet to real loud real quick. The Blues get a couple of goals in the second period. They tie it at two apiece. Coming up on the Jack in the Box intermission report, we'll take a look at our dirt cheap hit, see if somebody's giving somebody else the business. Plus, we'll hear from our Hall of Famer, Bernie Federko. And Bernie will give us his take on the second period and what lies ahead for the Blues as they get ready to go to the third period. The Blues having their way with the Oilers in the second period. Goals by Jaden Schwartz and Kevin Shattenkirk. In fact, Jaden Schwartz, who got the Blues on the board, has the headsets on and joins us now. And Jaden, what a difference in that second period. What changed for you guys?
Yeah, I mean, I don't think in the first we were all that bad. We just let off the gas pedal a little bit there the last 5 minutes, and that got us going, and it was good. Every line was going. I think that's the biggest thing. We were rolling four lines. Everyone was moving and getting pucks on net. That's the biggest part of our game plan.
You got moved up to the top line. It seems like you're in pretty good sync with those guys. What's it like playing with them?
It's a lot of fun. They're both great players. You know, it's an honor to be playing with them, and they're big, they're fast, they see the ice so well, so it's pretty easy to play with them.
What do you guys have to do to put this thing away in the third?
Just continue what we're doing. Keep rolling, keep the puck down low, and we know how skilled their forwards are. We want to make sure that we have the puck in their end instead of their coming back our way.
Thanks for the time. Go get a rest. You've been putting in a lot of minutes. A little winded is Jaden Schwartz, who gets his second. And the Blues now tied with the Oilers at two apiece after two periods of play. The Jack in the Box intermission report is straight ahead. The Hall of Famer, Bernie Federko, will join me right here on set. We're tied at two after two at Scott Trade.
It is 2-2 after 40 minutes of play here at Scott Trade as the Blues look to wrap up this three-game homestand with a W. John and Darren back in the broadcast with the Blues with two goals in that second. Real good, but Darren, they still gave up a few too many odd-man rushes, as Ray Bennett said during that intermission.
You know, and all the great goalies in the game find a way to battle through it. And there's times in the game, regardless of the score, that can result in a big save. And, you know, when the Oilers scored two goals in 23 seconds, it's a 2-0 game late. Now it can be a 3-0 game, and Hensley comes driving in. Yarrow goes paddled down, makes that save early then in the second period. He comes out acrobatically and nullifies what could be a breakaway, and then another golden opportunity on the power play. So it enabled the Blues to get back and claw their way back in this game, and now they've got themselves a game because Jaden Schwartz got things going, and then Shattenkirk scored on the power play.
And Schwartz has led all players tonight with six shots on goal. As we go to the third period, tied at two. Blues this year with, even after two, a record of 3-1-1. Edmonton is 0-4 when tied after two. It is Stewart, Berglund, and Perron for the Blues. As Gagne steps in for Edmonton. Between Hepsky and Jones. Underway third period. And the Oilers continue to withdraw. And that is flipped too high, and it goes out of play.
Well, we talked about that all WCHA college line to begin the game as Ken Hitchcock makes his switch. David Perron went down with Berglund and Stewart. But you look, Jaden Schwartz with his six shots, the captain with three, and you see Oshie with a couple of hits and a helper in this hockey game. So it has paid dividends, and it has been the best game, overall game, certainly, that Jaden Schwartz has played. He looks sharp on that line.
Now the Oilers back in their own zone. That's lobbed ahead by Hemsky. And on the back check, Stewart. Stolen from Jones.
That puck just won't lay flat, will it?
Here the Oilers. Jones tips it in. And Shattenkirk is the first man back for the Blues.
The puck doesn't even look like it's frozen, Banger. It looks like it's like soft rubber.
I totally agree with you. And you can really tell. I think some fans don't even realize that these pucks are kept frozen. And by being frozen, they lay flatter on the ice, and they're not so bouncy.
And that's kept in by Petrangelo. He walks right in a shot, and Dubnyk makes a great glove save on Petrangelo, who waltzed in on right wing.
Another good play, though, by Schwartz on the boards. And Schwartz, a good quick alert play, getting it over to Pietrangelo after Pietrangelo didn't bail out on the line. He's got such confidence holding the line, and because of that, he's got help behind him, and now he jumps into the play, tries to go high to the short side. Difficult to do with the big, tall, 6'5", Doobie Doobie Doo.
Who wears number 40? An iconic number for a goaltender.
It's a wonderful number. All the greats wore number 40.
Lewis win the faceoff. Russell a shot.
Rogatin Bashan.
Yes, he did, with the Detroit Red Wings. You're right.
And D'Agostini's shot blocked, and then fired wide by Sobotka. And then Ben Eager back to get it for Edmonton. And he'll chip it away. Russell swaps one ahead. Oh, D'Agostini blew a tire, but kept it moving ahead. And the Blues get it back.
He might have to go to Dobbs. Needs a new tread.
Always nice to get the sponsors a nice mention like that. And Russell on for Nickel. And then to Pollock in some heavy traffic, but the loose puck is grabbed by Russell. And Chris Russell negotiates his way to center ice. Russell from the tiny town of Caroline, Alberta, a couple of hours south of Edmonton. Now Crackle on the board, back of the line, Jackman. Over for Pietrangelo, and a shot. That was blocked. Right to Stewart, who didn't know where it was. And then Stewart is taken down by Peckerman behind the Edmonton goal. And then Nickel on the forecheck. Ties up Petrell. And a shot by Crackle got through and a save. Oilers try to clear it. At the line, it does come to center ice and then push back in. And now the Blues make a change on the fly.
Ken Hitchcock really, really, really preaching funneling pucks towards the net. And I tell you what, Cracknell takes that advice very well. Good save right there with the right pad on Hemsky. But Cracknell, every chance he gets, he is not hesitating to put the puck on net.
Now the Blues come in. Stewart, that shot was blocked. And now taken by Bergman, back for Shattenkirk toward the goal. That's blocked. And the Oilers out the other way. Hemsky lobs it in off a Blues player. Turned to the corner by Halak. And now picked up by David Perron in a 2-2 game. Here's Perron trying to hit Bergman down low. That bounced on him. And Vladislav Schmid for the Oilers. And then twisted onto center ice by Sam Gagne.
Pretty good hoister there by Gagne using the glass and then going for a line change there. But you do not count these Edmonton Oilers out of it. They've got some players that are absolutely dynamic and explosive. Got to keep the foot on the pedal here.
Now Schwartz. Oh, great pass in front of Backus. Snapped it wide. Now Schwartz again. Right in front. Oh, she is there. And he can't get it on goal. Boy, I tell you, Schwartz has been the Blues' best player tonight.
Yet.
Already a career high with 6 shots on goal after 2. And he has been around the puck all night long.
Little wraparound on his backhand right there, falling to his knees.
Now turned over, right to Schwartz. He looks for Backus, finds Backus, cuts in, and a backhander! And a save by Dubnyk, and then Nugent Hopkins lost the stick. Oilers Eager is hit by Backus. And then Russell comes in, but that pass tipped away. Back to center, walked back in by Pollock. Now to Porter. One shot blocked. And now the Blues working on the far side for Sobotka. And Vladdy Sobotka wanders back to the cage. Now a shot. He scores! Sobotka! And it's 3-2 for the Blues.
Holy jump, and he just rifles this high to the short side. Caught everybody by surprise. So good at protecting the puck. Admittedly had a tough game last night against Chicago. He bounces back as Cracknell gets thrown up there on the right side with Porter and Sobotka. And this one just kind of gets cupped on his blade, goes off the goaltender and in the net. Cracknell goes to the front of the net. Man, how did this get in? It looked like Dubnyk had it. It just goes right through him. But again, the team doing a better job of funneling pucks towards the net, and they're being rewarded for that now.
Sobotka's second of the year, first in 14 games since he scored the overtime winner against Minnesota. And the Blues lead for the first time. Now Peck Beckham gets it away from Reeves and the puck to center ice. So the Blues have scored the last three. It'll be a 3-2. As Cracknell gets the assist on the goal by Sobotka.
32, Bruce Porter.
And Porter the secondary assist. Now Jackman for Petrangelo. Good pass to Berglund. On to Perron. And then Jackman joins the play. Here's Jackman, a drive. Turned away by Dubnyk. Jackman now for Stewart. In behind the goal to Perron. Wide open. Oh, what a save by Dubnyk with his left pad. He robbed David Perron. And the Oilers come back. Here's Gagne. Trying to get free. Runs into Berglund, and now Berglund off the boards. And the Blues have 3-on-2 to center. But Stewart late on a shift. We'll just dump it in.
Does Dubnyk ever come back with a bounce-back save after that shot by Sobotka squirts underneath him? That was a brilliant save on Perron, who just has to get that up. And instead, the big pad comes swallowing that puck up.
As you would say, dooby-dooby-doo, with that save. And now Nick Schultz, number 15. Long stretch pass to Nugent Hopkins. He pulls up, trying to hit Yakupov down low, but Oshie got back to break it up. And the Blues have it. Don't clear it. Nugent Hopkins in front. Here's Eberle, and a backhander is fought off with the left arm of Yara Halak. And the Blues shoot it down the ice. And Nick Schultz was traded from Minnesota for Tom Gilbert. Now it's Yakubov. He'll twist one back for Schultz. Cracknell and Porter with the assist on the goal by Sobotka at 4:28.
Good for Cracknell, and he's played strong, and so they make the change with he and D'Agostini, and Cracknell gets a point.
And now Sobotka out of the corner, and a shot right on goal, and a save by Dubnyk. And then Pollock from the line. That shot failed to get through. And then Pollock again. He wanders in. Red shot. Off a stick to the corner. Porter recovers. And now for Cracknell, using his big body back to the Edmonton goal. And then Pollock comes in. Here's Pollock. Backhander. And that didn't get to the front. And the Oilers play it off the boards and out.
Great chip by Roman Pollock. The big boy from the Czech Republic. Moving his feet, keeping that puck in the zone, and because of that, the Blues end up getting a couple more chances.
Hey, you mentioned Cracknell with an assist tonight, now with 9 points in 27 NHL games.
Come in here and fit in quite nicely.
I like what you said, Panger, about him shooting from
everywhere.
Sharp angles. There's nothing wrong with doing that, and he's shooting it hard, too, at the net. And, I mean, Dubnyk has let in a couple of, you know what, maybe questionable goals, too, so keep shooting it.
Now the Blues to center ice, Stewart. Peckham steps up on him. And now Eberle comes in for the Oilers, one-on-one. Now waits for some late help. To the line to Peckham, a shot. And that trickles just wide. Comes back in front. And Jackman in the right spot.
That went off the big boy, Petrell, right in front of the net. Just dribbled by the glove side of Halak. Nearly went in.
11:45 left in the third period. The Blues with a 3-2 lead. The go-ahead goal by Sobotka. At 4:28. And it's Ryan Whitney, number six. Now for Schmid, long stretch pass. Here's Hemsky to the front, or rather Gagne. That was through the goal crease area. Schmid held it in. Now for Petrie. Gagne on the wing, a drive. That was blocked by Shattenkirk's stick. And the Oilers again on the cycle. Here's Hemsky around the goal. Right in front. Doesn't get it on Halak. Now Hemsky. And his shot, tip wide. And then Schmid could not hold it in on the left point.
Big break there. That was some good sustained pressure by the Hemsky line with Gagne as the center iceman. But the guy to watch here as this game goes on is going to be that Justin Schultz, the defenseman. He'll be jumping into the play in all situations as Edmonton's going to put a push on here.
Now Eberle, pass to the deep slot. And there's a shot right on goal. You mentioned Schultz, and there he was. Good call. Justin Schultz had walked in. And the Blues with it in. Fired to center ice by Oshie. Back in for Eberle. Eberle a shot. Didn't get through. Blocked by Russell. And then Oshie run off the puck in the corner. Oilers have picked it up here in the last 3 minutes. And now Sobotka starts back to center ice. And off the boards and in. As he pressures Nick Schultz. Now Porter helps out. In comes Ryan Reeves. And Reeves to the corner. Reeves gets it back from Porter. is in the midst of a line change. Now Nickel trying to get away from his man. Nickel on the cycle for Reeves, picked up by Cracknell. Now Cracknell stops and starts on Justin Schultz. Cracknell gets it free to Reeves. Back for Jackman. Off the end boards, comes right in front. That was a set play. As Jackman did not have a shooting lane, now the Oilers go for a bad line change. Petrangelo a drive and a save by Dubnyk on that 35-footer by Petrangelo. And a break in the action. 9:37 to go. Sabotka has put the Blues up 3-2. Trying to make it 21 in a row without a regulation loss. An amazing run by Joel Quenneville's club.
Unbelievable. That coaching staff has done a great job there in Chicago.
Now the Blues who lead 3-2. Perron, Berglund, and Stewart up front. Oilers get it back, and Theo Pekham has it.
You think that Jack Adams is heading over that way?
Well, Coach Quenneville won it, I believe, in 2000. Here's a drive by Belanger right on goal. And a good save by Halak. That shot was tipped on the way through.
Yeah, a little change in the lines here for the head coach of the Edmonton Oilers, Ralph Kruger, because we have not seen Taylor Hall return. So not on the bench, not at this particular point. So a little change up there in rotation. And Belanger with that shot. He's looking for Eager to drive hard to the net. And that nearly handcuffs Halak, but he squeezes it off. Interesting thing about Jaro Halak. He wears all that white equipment. And Jaro Halak spent all morning. He loves to have his equipment nice and clean. And he doesn't like it when these pads get dirty. So he gets the oil out and he just was rubbing this morning and making sure that they look nice and spotless, thinking they look sharper and they look bigger when they're all nice and white and clean. That's a meticulous goaltender, Bernie.
Yes, it's not Snow White, though.
And a drive right on goal by Petrie. And that was turned away by the clean white pads of Jaro Halak. Kept in speed. Off the corner glass. Jones was in the area. Now Schmid pinches in, runs Oshie down. And the puck trickles back to center ice. And now it is Jeff Petrie. Son of the former Tiger pitcher. Oilers come up the middle. Hemsky.
David Backus had a chance there. I think to go right through Hemsky. Kind of laid off there, didn't he?
Now Backus to center ice for Schwartz. And Jaden Schwartz sends it in. Both clubs make changes on the fly.
Yeah, and now D'Agostini rejoins the line of Sobotka and Porter.
And Nugent Hopkins can't get it deep. Petrangelo back to center. Nugent Hopkins again. In for Justin Schultz.
Every time the puck gets into that offensive zone, Schultz and gets on the ice on a line change. There he nearly caught them by surprise again. But the pass was off the mark.
And that's an icy call. Well, Blues fans ever want to take a ride on the Zamboni or participate in one of the intermission games? Well, now you can simply check out the Fan Zone page at stlouisblues.com and sign up.
You were once a Zamboni driver.
Yes, I was at Creve Coeur Ice Arena in Castle Oak here in St. Louis.
With the legendary First Bank Joe Ambrose, I believe.
Yes, he was my boss. And he went from a Zamboni driver to the president of First Bank.
And you got stuck with me as Bernie. What happened there?
Oh, I hit the lottery. You know that. Now Nugent Hopkins back in for Edmonton. And that goes wide. Yakupov fires it in front. And Justin Schultz in for Eberle. And then the Blues shoot it around the boards. At the line, Nick Schultz kept it in there. Eberle back of the goal, squeezed off the puck by Stewart. And the Blues recover. On to center ice now for Petrangelo. Gets to the red line. 7:07 left in regulation time, and the Blues up 3-2. And one time trail 2-0. But goals from Schwartz, Shattenkirk, and Sobotka. As the Blues up by one. Rifled in by Theo Pekham. Russell up for Nickel. And then Nickel is shouldered by Ben Eager. Now Belanger trying to go to the line. That was blocked. Centered in front. Oh, and Eager was behind the defense. Now Eager gets it. And out of midair, swatted away by Nickel. And it goes all the way down. This will be an icing call against the Blues.
Roman Polak just got his stick there in the nick of time. Otherwise, Eagers right in front of the net on a bang-bang play. A good stick there by the big fella, Roman. Focus on the slot on the left side of your screen there. Roman got caught a little bit high, but he made up for it, getting back quickly.
Off the faceoff, Hemsky now for Whitney. Great pass in front, Gagne's wide open, back for the slot. No one was there, Gagne really should have shot that.
What a pass by Whitney again. He has made some excellent plays with the puck.
Well, leads around to Crackle, he was pelted from behind. Oilers get it back, and then Peckham's shot was about 4 feet high. And then Hemsky, because of that icing call, the Blues couldn't make a line change, and now they're running around here. Oilers get it. Back on the line again for Whitney. Jones back on the goal, and then Russell steps in front of the Oiler player to break it up, right in front of Hemsky, and now it's finally lobbed away by Cracknell.
Quick read there by Russell, and getting right in front of Hemsky. Otherwise, you give Hemsky a little bit of time, he gives you the nine of hearts.
Speaking of the nine of hearts, Everly almost gave one to Redden, but a poke check by Halak. Oilers get it back. But now it's stolen by Schwartz. Center ice to Oshie around Schmid. Here's Oshie to Backes. Oh, what a play! Backes makes it 4-2.
Oh, my! Some sick hands there by Oshie on the far side. And he kind of stutter-stepped around Schmid. These fans are on their feet. Why wouldn't they be? It's a 4-2 Blues lead. Right here's the play. Whoa, from the inside to the outside. One hand on his stick. He feathers it underneath. And David Backes cashes in. Petrie goes down early. The open man is Backes. He's not sure it's in, but it rattles off the post and in the net. From the left post to the middle of the net.
What a play by Oshie and Backes. His third of the year, first goal in 9 games. And the Blues with a 4-2 lead. And here's another 2-on-1. It's D'Agostini. And he had his shot partially blocked by Petrie.
And number 9, Jaden Schwartz.
Oshie and Schwartz get the assist on the goal. So Jaden Schwartz, a 2-point night. And the Blues with a 2-goal lead. Darren, this is only the second time in the last 8 games they've had a 2-goal lead at any point in any of those games.
Well, they didn't let this game get away from them. Still plenty of time on the clock here for this tricky Oilers team. But still, the Blues give them credit. Down 2-0 after losing last night against their arch rival, the Blackhawks. They bounce back here.
And a drive by Hemsky goes wide. And then the shot by Jones off a stick on the glass. And now Redden trying to clear it away. Get some help there from Stewart. And Stewart will fire it in. Oilers score 2 late goals in the first period. Up by 2. Blues tied into the second. Goal from Schwartz and Shattenkirk. And 2 more in the third by Sobotka and Backes. And now Redden has it. And around for Backes. Whitney pinches and the Blues get it. And it's Schwartz again for Oshie. Moves in a shot. That was blocked. Gets his own rebound. And the Oilers get it away from Oshie. And now back for Gagne. Under 4 to play, third period. Here's Everly. 1-on-2 and a right pad save by Halak.
How good was Everly in the American Hockey League during the lockout? 25 goals. In only 34 games played, and he's still fourth most in the American Hockey League.
With 51 points. And the Blues on the attack. Yeah, Crackle was talking about that this morning. They had quite the team in Oklahoma City, but the Rivermen did beat them one night. All those young stars were down in Oklahoma City.
Yeah, including Justin Schultz, the defenseman, who had 18 goals in only 34 games played. Amazing.
Even Taylor Hall was down there.
Yep.
Now the Blues in their own zone. Petrangelo. And then for Berglund. with 2:45 to go. Now Dubnyk sets it up for Petrie. And Eager tips it back to center ice. There's Perron in the forecheck, but the Oilers get it in Belanger to center ice. Stripped of the puck by Backes. Now Perron trying to cut in. In the back of the goal, Backes in the area. Puck comes around. And turning is the veteran, Ryan Smith. Chopped ahead, Ben Eager. Chopped down by Pollock. And the Blues send it back into the Oilers zone.
Keep your eye on Devin Dubnyk. He looked like he was trying to communicate with the bench. Yes, Ralph Krueger is pulling the goaltender. 2 minutes left to go in the game.
Coming up, Missouri Lottery Blues Live. Six attackers here for Edmonton. Oshie gets it off the window and out. And now played by Whitney for Justin Schultz. Six attackers. Here are the Oilers. Petrel comes in on the back check. And Petrangelo broke it up. Oilers play one to the corner. Gagne is hit by Sobotka. And then in the corner, Pollock ran Petrel to the ice. Oilers get it out high. Quick shot. In a stick goes to the near corner. Grabbed by Gagne. Gagne backdoor feed for Jones. He was there.
Pass. He was looking towards the point, Justin Schultz, and he fired it right across.
And now Petrangelo knocks it down. Off the boards and out. And Whitney wins the foot race there against Chris Porter. With 70 seconds left here in the third period. Oilers tip it back in. And Halak sets it up for Jackman. Comes around. And it does roll to center ice. Final minute now in the third period. And Oshie at the empty net. That will go too high.
That would have been something. You don't see that very often. The old alley-oop into the empty net trick.
The old Bob Plager flip shot. Here are the Oilers again. Eberle up the middle. Eberle a backhand pass back in front. Now Yakupov shoots it wide. Ryan Smith in front. Eugene Hopkins in the area. And there's Oshie again with that flipper. And back to center ice in the final 30 seconds.
When you work on things in practice, you can execute it in the game. And he does it all the time.
Eberle to Ryan Smith, a drive, and he put that one high. And then Perron off the far boards with an empty net. Here's Perron, and a shot. That was blocked. And then Sobotka, who it appears will get the game-winning goal tonight. Oilers get it back. Five to go. And that'll do it. Krakko shoots it down the ice, and the Blues, a big come-from-behind win. Behind Halak, 4-2 in the final.
Great way to get the morale back and the confidence. After the Blues have been struggling on home ice, they even it to 5-5-1 now, and a chance to go on the road on a winning note.
Big win, Bernie Federko.
Yes, an awful big win. Listen to the crowd. You can just see the excitement from the guys. But, guys, before we get to the three stars, let's take a look at tonight's Mazda drive to the net. And the fourth goal tonight by David Backes. Look at the great play by David, or by Oshie. But David Backes going to the net, off the post, and in the insurance goal. So more of the celebration. So what a night for the Blues, guys.
And tonight's Bud Light player of the game is the rookie, Jaden Schwartz. The native of Melford, Saskatchewan, with a heck of a night. 2 points and a career-high 6 shots on goal.
Well, in a night when it's pink at the rink, we all know that Jaden Schwartz lost his sister Mandy to acute myeloid leukemia a little while ago. A special night for Jaden Schwartz and a wonderful opportunity playing on the top line with Backes and Oshie. And boy, he didn't disappoint. He had an excellent hockey game, as did Backes and TJ Oshie.
So the Blues win it 4-2. They go to 11-7-2. The Oilers fall to 8-8-4. And the Blues have now won their last 6 games at home against Edmonton. Time for the three stars.
Three stars of tonight's game. The game's third star, scoring 1 assist and playing out of forward for the Blues, number 79, Adam Cracknell. The game's second star with 1 goal and 1 assist, playing out of forward for the Blues, number 17, Vladimir Sobotka. And the game's first star, with one goal and one assist, playing in a forward for the Blues, number 9, Jaden Schwartz.
Well, the first start of the game, Jaden Schwartz. Congratulations, Jaden. Now, how good does this feel to get a big win after, especially after the loss last night against the Blackhawks?
Yeah, it's nice. It's our last home game for a while, and it's a big win for us. Down 2-0, coming back and scoring 4 on Astros is pretty special.
I was going to ask you about that. You guys are down pretty good first period you played. A couple of mistakes within 30 seconds, you're down 2-0. What was said in the locker room? Was it amongst the guys, or did Kane Hitchcock say something to you after that first period?
Well, we knew we played pretty good that period. One thing we haven't been doing as much as we'd like is playing a full 60 minutes. You know, we took a couple minutes off, bang, bang, it's 2-0 for them. So I think something we're learning still is you got to play full 60 minutes. And against skilled forwards like that, you can't make mistakes or turn pucks over. So, Hitch said stuff, but we knew we had to be better too.
And for you, new line mates tonight in Backes and Oshie. I know you haven't had the offensive time that you would like so far this season, but how did it feel to fit in with those two guys?
It was a lot of fun. They're both really special players. They're so smart. They see the ice very well, and it was easy for me to play with them, so it was a lot of fun.
Well, congratulations on not only the win, but on the goal. Keep it going on the road.
All right, thank you very much.
The first star, Jaden Schwartz, with a two-point night as the Blues win it 4-2.